Chacon is definitely a journey, and you feel it from the outset. You know you're in for something very powerful and amazing. And then Bach manages to take you through the entire range of human emotion. Through discovery and longing and joy and spirituality, ecstasy, and then resignation and redemption, and finally a sort of triumph, you might say. With the Chacon, you have to think on so many different levels as a performer. You have to think of the overall structure and the pacing of the piece, which is so hard to get just right. Then you have to think on a smaller level on the individual phrases and individual variations, and of course all the technical difficulties. If someone comes away listening to Chacon feeling so moved by the power of Bach, that's the greatest compliment, rather than someone saying, oh, great fiddler, you know, that's not what I'm after. There's something incredibly direct about Bach's music that will always be appealing. Something innately, when you listen to it, something that rings so true when you hear music that's based on something small like that, and it stimulates the mind, and perhaps it imitates life itself. The Chacon is based on something very, very simple. It's just a very small motif, repeated variations on this one motif over and over again. And the motif is simply really four descending notes, and that's it. Scientists are constantly trying to find the basic laws of physics, for instance. You know, there are only 100 or so elements, and they make up every single compound in the universe. Or the DNA, you know, only made up of, I don't know, what is it, four nucleotides or whatever it is. I don't remember my biology. But those four little things in different combinations make up our entire DNA. So I think there's something very appealing as human beings when we see this kind of thing happen, and that's what happens in Bach's music.